Even a well-lit place can hide salvation. A map to one man maze that never sees the sun. Where are the lost? Are the heroes and the thieves are left to drown? Everyone knows by now fairy tales are not.
Hey guys, this is Paladin Exotics here. I'm about to do an unboxing video for Rainbow Mealworms, some super worms and stuff. At the end, I'll make a little, you'll see this plan again, I'll make a little secondary part, and I'll tell you about how I thought of their service and everything. So let's get started on the video. This is Paladin Exotics. I'm going to unboxing a package from Rainbow Mealworms. One of the many one-handed YouTube unboxings that will occur over the period of your lifetime. There you go. That's pretty good. My classy buck knife. Let's see here. This is 250 superworms. This is 1,000 more superworms. As you can probably hear. Yummy. Then we have 50 waxworms. The extremely expensive but always good for your animals unicorns. Some dubious. And then we've got, of course, the hornworms. I'm gonna get the ones that are gonna be housed in anything but their enclosures. I'm gonna go ahead and put those in new enclosures, and I'll get back to you.
Okay, guys, I have the superworms inside their container now. As you can see, there's a whole bunch of them, about 1,250. And Kimber, the Great Dane, is really intrigued right now. She has no clue what these are. And then I think I'm gonna put some potatoes in here, and then I'll get on to the next thing. It's pretty full of superworms. And now I'm just gonna kind of fill it up with a large amount of potato, which they will eat very quickly if past experience serves me correctly. Okay. And then here are my ones that are pupating currently. They've been in there for a few days. As of the recording of this. And then now we'll go ahead and start with the roaches, which are not crazy big, but they're not really for feeding at this point in time, so that will be just fine. I've grown dubious before, but I ended up having to actually feed off all of my breeders, so this is going to be a good experience getting to breed them again. Okay, and I'll probably just end up using the bucket they sent as a feeding dish. Wow, you can really get in there. These aren't really medium, but I'm not really complaining because I'm not feeding them currently. They should spread out in there. That looks kind of violent, but it's not really going to hurt them. And there are my two easiest ones to get out. Alright, cool. No, they'll propagate in here. This has a heat pad on the bottom of it, so it'll be nice and warm for them. All I have to do now is make them a food dish. And what I'll do is I'll probably just like scratch the side of this up so they can climb in and out of it. And it'll work kind of great. Or I could do something like cut a hole on the top of this and just slide it in, but I'll probably just end up dremeling it. Alright, now on to the hornworms. Okay, the roaches are all set up, but they're nice big red number thing. They got some dog food there and some water crystals. I will be giving them fruit periodically, but you're not supposed to give them fruit all the time. And also, I wanted to cut back on the fruit just a little bit so that they wouldn't be getting fruit flies in there, which is always a bad thing. And I moved the hornworms over here so they'd be by some heat. And what I was saying earlier about the roaming stage is what they'll do is, that, like these big ones, they'll go down here and they'll become this pale color almost, and they won't climb anymore. And that's when you put them in, if you want them to pupate, you put them in some dirt, some like potting soil, and then they'll bury underneath the potting soil and pupate, and then you can turn them into moths. Okay guys, the dubias are all set up, the superworms are all set up, so now we're just going to go ahead and real quick go through the worms that will not be being, the worms and insects that won't be being stored in a separate enclosure than what they were shipped in. This is basically going to be their enclosure through the entire process of me feeding them off. At this point in time, I'm not really thinking about pupating them, because I don't really have anything to hold the moths in that would properly care for them. Maybe in the future I'll do a breeding project on these, but as of right now, the only thing I'm going to be breeding is the superworms and the cockroaches. They can get pretty big. They're called hornworms. Hey, Kimber. Come on in. You're making this hard to video. Anyway, so these are called tomato hornworms or tobacco hornworms or just hornworms, depending on where you're from. They're really good feeders because they're, as you can see there, they get very large before they actually pupate and turn into the tomato moths. If you were to feed these tomato plants, they actually become toxic to your animals, which is why you see this weird brown sludge at the top, is because when they eat that, they get that bright green color, and they're edible. And then here are the waxworms, and the waxworms are a good kind of like side dish, if you will, but they're not good as a main constant food source because of their high fat content, which can actually give the reptiles fatty liver disease, which will kill them surprisingly fast. But as a treat or something to get them, or to add a few extra grams for breeding season, it's a great additive to their diet. And then next are the black soldier fly larvae, which are called phoenix worms. They're kind of expensive, but they're really good for the animals, so I don't mind really. There's a bunch in here. I saw them just a second ago. There's some. They're maggots for black soldier flies. And the black soldier flies are actually commonly used in compost and stuff to help the process go along. So these have a variety of different people who purchase them, not just an animal. Like people who are feeding their animals. So I think that's all for now. I'll go ahead and do the quick review at the end here. You'll get to see my beautiful plant again. And then we'll do the outro, and you guys can have a great day. Well, that was actually pretty good. There was very few dead, and if it was dead, it was there was so few it didn't matter. It was very good, and the ones that I'm not going to be breeding, of course, they all were alive, so that's good. None of the roaches were dead, so, and then also they had great service, they answered all my questions. It was here really quick, so I have no complaints. Oh.